أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إنا أعطيناك الكوثر فصل لربك وانحر إن شانئك هو الأبتر صدق الله العظيم. This is Surah Kausar, and Surah Kausar was revealed on Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, in Meccan life. The Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, had two sons from Hazrat Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha. The first son was Qasim, and then Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, had four daughters, and then Hazrat Khadija gave a son to Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, and his name was Abdullah, and he was also given the titles of Tayyib and Tahir. The Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, was busy in the mission of prophethood, and the opposition was on its peak when Hazrat Abdullah passed away in infancy. So the enemies of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, were very happy at this occasion. And As bin Wail came to the other Meccan leaders and he said that Muhammad has become Abtar. They made fun of Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, by calling him Abtar. The word Abtar literally means a tailless animal, but in Arabic literature, the word is used for a person who has no male offspring. It is also used for a person who has no future hope, a person who is left alone by his friends and by his relatives. For in this sense, they used the word Abtar for Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, and they thought that because he has no male offspring, so when Muhammad will die, we will get rid of his religion and we will get rid of his teachings. It was a way of thinking of the Meccan people. They gave a lot of importance to male offspring if a person wants his name to be continued in the world. So they were making fun of the Holy Prophet by calling him Abtar, and the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, was obviously very upset and aggrieved at this moment. On one side, he was upset on the death of his son, and on the other side, his enemies were making fun of him. So to console the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, Allah sent down Surah Kausar. The main theme of the surah is consolation of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. But in the surah, Allah consoled Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, in a different way, other than Surah Ad-Duha. Over here, Allah said, "Inna a'tainaka al-kawthar," indeed we have granted you abundance. The word kawthar is derived from the word kasrat. The word kasrat means plenty of something, abundance of something. There are many possibilities in the explanation, in the interpretation of this word here. Some of the ulama say that over here it refers to abundance of his spiritual offspring. Allah is consoling his messenger that Muhammad, don't worry on the death of your son, because we are going to give you abundance of his spiritual descendants. You know that the wives of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, are termed as Ummahatul Mu'mineen in the Holy Quran, that they are the mothers of the believers. So the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, is just like father for his followers, but spiritually and not physically. So as a father wants his son to be there in the world so that he can continue his mission, because of him his name will be remembered in the world, the same thing is going on for Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, through his countless and abundant spiritual offsprings of the Prophet. They spread his message in the world, they follow him, they praise him. So Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, is still remembered with finest words in the world through his spiritual descendants. The word abundance can also refer to the abundance of his spiritual benefits as well. Allah is saying to Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, that Muhammad, though we have taken back your son from you, but on the other side, don't you see that we have given you so many spiritual benefits which are not given to anyone else? Like Allah gave you prophethood, and not only prophethood, but Allah has made you the Sayyidul Anbiya, the leader of all prophets, and Allah made you the final and the universal messenger. And Allah also gave you the knowledge of the Holy Quran. So these are the spiritual benefits. So Allah is consoling his messenger, saying that though we have taken away something from you, but on the other side we have given you a lot as well. So you should look on both the sides of the picture. If something is taken back, on the other side Allah has given you so many things. So when Holy Prophet will think like that, he will get consolation, he will get satisfaction. And the word Kausar, according to some reports, also refers to a river in paradise, which is a unique river, and it will be given to Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, on the judgment day, and he will be offering water from this river to his followers, and it will be a great honor for Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. So Allah consoled him that though we have taken back from you your son, but on the other side we are going to honor you with the river Kausar on the judgment day. Allah consoled his messenger in another way in the surah. Allah said, Inna shani'aka huwal abtar, that Muhammad, don't worry, the people who are making fun of yours by calling you abtar, in the long run they will be rootless, they will be cut off, and they will be having no future. And it happened within the life of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, that his enemies were slain in front of him in the Battle of Badr. The Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, finally entered Makkah as a conqueror. The Holy Prophet, peace be upon him's mission achieved and his message prevailed. And all of his enemies were either killed in the battles or they accepted Islam finally. So they themselves proved to be Abtar and not the messenger of Allah. Allah consoled Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, in many other occasions of life, like Allah consoled Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, in Surah Duha, as we discussed earlier, that when Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, had a long break in revelations and his enemies were making fun of him on that break, Allah consoled him by revealing Surah Duha, and Allah gave the very good answer of the objections raised by the Quraysh against the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. From this surah, Muslims can learn lots of things today. First of all, the surah tells us about the high rank of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, in the sight of Allah, that Allah could not see his messenger in sorrow and grief. When the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, was upset and disappointed, Allah himself came to console him, and Allah consoled him in a very nice way, saying, Inna a'tayna kal kawthar. So it tells us about the strong relationship of Allah with his messenger. We also learn from here that everything happens according to Allah's plans. We should not object on the planning of Allah. The death of the Holy Prophet's son obviously was according to the planning of Allah. So Allah ordered Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, to remain patient on it. So whatever happens in a Muslim's life today or anyone's life, it happens according to the plan of Allah. And a believer has to accept it as Allah's decision, and we are given lots of rewards on our patience, and we should not make objections on it. And we should keep in mind that all the plannings of Allah are based on some wisdom. The death of the Holy Prophet's son, there can be a wisdom. Like Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, said in a hadith, that if I had any son, so he would be a prophet. Like all other messengers, many other messengers had their sons as messengers of Allah. Like Hazrat Ibrahim had two sons, both of them became the messengers of Allah. Then Hazrat Ishaq's son, Yaqub alayhi salam, became the messenger of Allah. Hazrat Zakaria's son, Yahya alayhi salam, became the messenger of Allah. So obviously the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, if he had son, so he had to be the messenger of Allah. It could be the honor for Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. But Allah had no plan to send any other messenger after the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. So this was the reason that Allah took away the son of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. So we should accept all the decisions of Allah with patience, believing that there must be a wisdom in it. And in the second verse of the surah, Allah said, Fasalli li Rabbik, pray for your Lord. So why Allah ordered the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, for prayers at that occasion, at the occasion of grief, at the occasion of the death of his son? Because prayer gives us the lesson of submission to God. Prayer gives us satisfaction. The Holy Quran says that Allah bi dhikrillahi tatma'innul qulub, with the remembrance of Allah the hearts get satisfied. And the best way for the remembrance of Allah is none other than salah. So when Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, will offer prayer at that moment, so that he will remember that everything is in Allah's control. We have to submit ourselves to God, and it will give him spiritual satisfaction. So it is a lesson for all the believers that whenever they are in grief, they are in sorrow, so they should turn to Allah, offer the prayer, because prayer gives us that spiritual strength to endure the hardships of life. There is a verse in Surah Baqarah where Allah says, وَاسْتَعِينُوا بِالصَّبْرِ وَالصَّلَاةِ. Seek help with prayer and patience. So prayer is a way to get patience and to get strength to face the hardships of life and the difficulties of life. And Allah also said to Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, وَنْحَرْ, that do the sacrifice. Why Allah ordered to give sacrifice over here? Because sacrifice also gives us a lesson of submission and devotion to Allah. When we do sacrifice, we are not just slaughtering that goat. That is just a symbol. We want to show that we are ready to sacrifice everything we have for the sake of Allah. At the time of sacrifice, you know, we say, Inna salati wa nusuki wa mahyaya wa mamati lillahi rabbil alameen ala sharika lah. Indeed, my prayer and my sacrifice and my life and my death is for Allah, Lord of the worlds. So look at the wordings of this dua and this ayah, how submissive wordings are there, that our life and our death and everything belongs to us, is actually belongs to Allah. Allah has given all the things to us and Allah can take these things back at any time. So Allah is the real owner. And when Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, will do the sacrifice, he will obviously remember Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salam, who initiated sacrifice. And Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, will remember that Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salam was ready to slaughter his son with his own hand for the sake of Allah, for the pleasure of Allah. So if Allah has taken back my son, so I should also remain patient on it, because I am a follower of Ibrahim alayhi salam and I have to follow his sunnah. The Holy Quran says, وَاتَّبِعْ مِلَّةَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ حَنِيفًا. Follow the faith of Ibrahim, the upright. So in this way, these two commands are very relevant and it teaches Muslims that they should, in the time of grief, at the time of sorrow, should give the sacrifice to Allah and they should turn to Allah and praise Him and worship Him. And another important lesson for us from the surah is that the only way to be successful in this life and in the second life is to love the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, obey him, respect him. This is the only way for our success. And whoever will reject him, whoever will make fun of him, and whoever will ignore the guidance of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, he will have no future and he will be cut off finally in the long run in his life. May Allah give us the tawfiq to follow all these teachings of the surah. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.